Hey guys, Tarek with Cyclone FPV, and I am actually doing some grunt work, I guess. Basically, I'm trying to repair some pretty messed up quads, so I'm going to be doing this here. I'm not sure if there's a bunch of information that might be new to you or whatever, but you can at least see kind of what we're doing here. So let me go ahead and just get this going here, and I'm going to try to get me some light without interfering. I don't know how I'm going to pull this off, but we'll see if we can make it work somehow. Let's see if I can put that over here. If you give me a little light. All right. I know that's probably going to be a little bothersome, but it's all right. So anyways, this drone, this one got sent in to me. It's been smashed to hell and back. So I am right now, I have gutted it and wiped it down. And right now what I'm trying to do is I'm just trying to test the ESC, see if there's any life in this thing. This is really kind of screwed up. And so even the wiring is damaged. I mean, look at everything about this is screwed up. And so I figured, well, it is an RMA, but it's not something like the normal RMAs. This is like not somebody saying, hey, just quit working. This is like, hey, I ran it into the road at 100 miles an hour, and it doesn't work anymore. So sometimes we try to help everybody out by fixing them if we can at the lowest price possible. Right now, it's not the best time for everybody to be spending money on this, I know. So, but I also know that it gives everybody a nice outlet for letting off some steam and then go fly. So I want to make sure we give them a chance at least to get back in the air. So the problem is, I think the ESC might be damaged too. And the reason I say that is I believe it failed earlier, but I had to clean it up. So I'm going to see if that cleaning it up fixed it. I have my doubts, but we're going to find out. All right, let's get this last motor on here. And basically what I want to see is I want to see if this thing's going to even initialize. That's why I'm just kind of putting the motors, you know, kind of quickly just soldering them, because I need to see if this, sorry about that. I need to see if these are just going to even initialize. All right, so where did I put the flight controller? This flight controller had seen better days too. This whole quad has seen better days. I sold this quad new to this person. It has gone through Beirut and back. So let me get all this crap out of here. I need to try to clean up my workbench here. Anyway, everything okay? You can put it on two-way now if you want.
No, I'm going to be too close to it, so I'll keep it
up. All right, so let's see. We've got to find the flight controller here. I believe this is the flight controller. There it is. And I'm not really sure. Let me see. I'm going to take this cable, this flight controller, and I'm going to see if we can make anything good happen out of this. And if not, then we might be out of luck. We've got two flight controllers plus a new one. Two used ones and a new one here. So I've got two identical quads that are in the same repair. Two different people. They don't even know each other. But they both, they're not identical quads, but they're very close. They both had a very bad issue, bad mishap. All right, so I'm going to leave that like that for now. See if I can get the see if I can get any kind of response out of this. I can't get it to initialize at all. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go grab a new ESC, and I'm gonna try to figure out if it's the ESC or the flight controller. But I don't really think it's the flight controller. So let me go and grab an ESC. Give me 1 second. I'll be right back. Okay, here's the ESC. There's another flight controller if we need it, but right now I'm just gonna look for the ESC. All right, so let me do this, take this off. I guess we'll take these wires off one more time. 1, 2, and 3. We're gonna let that board rest a little bit, okay? I have a feeling it's done, but I'm gonna hold out hope. All right, so I need to get this board ready. I need to see if I can find my, All right, I'll just do it like that. I've got pretty much no room left on this bench because there's so many repairs to do. So let's just work with it like this, okay? I'm gonna go ahead and use the flux pen. Okay, and I'm gonna heat the board up just a little bit. Okay, and now let's go ahead and tin it. Okay, and let's give us some, let's see, I guess we'll do a LiPo XT60. I really don't like doing this part. If I don't know if it's gonna work, because if it's not needed, then I'm not ahead and already added the XT60. All right, I got a little bit more time on this before it gets too hot, so I can keep my finger on it, but I can tell that probably about another 20 seconds of this and I'm gonna be about done trying to keep my finger on here. Let's see if this will work. All right, so there's our setup, right? And oops, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna take that old board here. I'm just gonna, actually, this thing's toast. So let me find an XT65. Strong plugs, I like these. Alright, so let's go ahead and try to get this somewhat set up. So to do that, I'm going to pre-tin. Even though the wire's already pre-tinned, I want to put my solder on there so that it'll melt quicker. Because the factory solder from AMAS is really like high temp, and I don't feel like dealing with that. So if I can just put this on there, get it to hold just long enough so that I can solder this, we might be in good shape. So let's see what happens. Go ahead and continue on this side a little bit. There we go. Now we're getting it where we want it. Okay, once I get it situated, go ahead and hold this down. It's pretty solid on there. Okay. Well, that's to the ground. that should be enough that we can see the heat pass through and get us down onto that pad properly. I need this to just sit still. And usually I have my little circuit mount, or I have this in the drone already, but I didn't do that this time. So let's see if I can just get this to sit here. Now, let me do this real quick. Okay, so now I'm just going to clean it up, and then we should be good to test it out. Since it's brand new, I'm not too worried about anything going super wrong here. Just want to... Now we're going to let the heat pass through, and we should be able to get... Alright, let's see. Kind of wanted a little bit more over here, but... There we go. All right. So it looks like we're good there. Both pads are on nicely. Okay. A bit longer than normal, but it's not hot where you can't hold it. So it's warm, but that's good enough. I mean, these are on pretty good. Whoops. I was cranking down the heat on the soldering iron and totally missed my mark here. Give me 1 second. Okay. Now with that done, we're going to let the solder iron cool down a little bit too. We're going to prep this. We're going to try to get this ready so that we can test it in here. And this time I'm just going to go ahead and put the white cable. Where is it? Where did I put that cable in? Is it still attached? Nope. Oh, it didn't work. Yeah,
there it is. I knew it.
I remembered it. Oh. Okay, so let's go ahead and do this. Here. There we go. I'm not gonna... I guess I could put these spacers, but I'm not... Well, you know what? Never mind. I'll go ahead and do that. Take these off of this one. Go ahead and put this in. Alright. Okay. Now, I'm going to re-solder the motor wires again, just kind of quickly. Nothing crazy. I just want to get it ready to go so we can test it again. So let's just do this. It should melt on there pretty darn quick. One. Two. Three. All right. That being said, I'm going to pull the old flight controller, which is right here. Pins lined up. Okay, there we go. So I wanted to hear. Perfect. That's what we needed. So at the end of the day, it looks like we have a bad ESC. So we're going to go ahead and finish this job out now. All right, so we need to put just a few things we need to do before we can put this away. Now I get to actually take this motor off again. Well, actually, no, I don't have to. I just need to get on this side of the board, I guess. Okay. Prep this side. Oh, it's not on. God. All right. Well, we can at least make sure it fits, right? So, yeah, it looks like it fits pretty good. Shouldn't be any problems there at all. So that's fine. Just take this up. Okay. Now, while this is kind of waiting for that to happen, I'm going to make sure everything else looks good. It does. So let's go ahead and get the rest of the motor wires ready. I don't look pretty, that's for sure. So let's go ahead and get some flux paste on them. Try to get them cleaned up at least. Hey, babe. How you doing?
Hot.
Smoking.
Not that way.
Yeah. Love you.
Thank you.
Did you decide what you want to do for dinner, Mama?
Watermelon.
Watermelon for dinner. All right, I'm down. Okay. So that's done. Let's see how our glue gun's going. I think it's ready. So I'm going to go ahead and just turn this around. Let's see. Guess not. So wait a little bit longer. Alright. So with that, we can at least let's clean up the table. Get all the grass stains off these motors. Suckers have been through. I'm telling you, it's like a little Beirut. Okay. Thank you. Now let's see. There we go. Coffee break, and then we'll close this up. All right, first things first. One of the things that I thought HGLRC could have done, and it's not a criticism as much as just as an observation, I would have rather seen a, like this. And again, this is just observation. Like everybody, you know, when you get to see what they've done, you can always play, what do you call that, armchair quarterback or backseat driver or whatever it is. I would have liked to have seen something like this, just anything to separate the capacitor, you know, from touching the carbon fiber in a hard hit. So I'm going to put some double-sided tape, but I'm not going to take off the other side. It doesn't need to be sticky. I just want to put something that prevents us from touching the carbon fiber in a hard hit, in a hard landing, right? Or even just even when it's pressed in right now. So let me go ahead and get these wires out of the way. And we can see what we're working with. First thing is to make sure that, perfect. See, and that's what I want you to see. So you see that right there? So once you tighten this down, right? That look at that. That's the capacitor right there touching the tape, right? So I'm glad there's something there now. I think they should have done that before, but it's neither here nor there. That's just, what's there? It's here nor there. Whatever. So anyways, I'm gonna go ahead now and get these motors soldered on, and then I'll come back and redo this one. So let's get going, shall we? I'm just going to put a small spacer on here. I've got one, something I can fasten down with, something like this, just to hold the board in place. All right, so I'm just going to put one of these on here so the board doesn't keep sliding out. And then we're going to go to the other side here. Let's start on this side right now. side now. Okay, and so now what I want to do is I'm just going to run a very quick line right here. There we go. I'm come back now and just finish this one here. Redo it. Pretty sure. Let me just see. It was not. Okay, now let's straighten them out down here. Okay, now that that's done, the next thing we want to do is we want to get the flight controller ready. We know this piece is broken here, so I'm going to just go ahead and heat it up real quick anyway. Get this receiver off, so let's do that. So the idea will be to put this right here like this and have this cable come up here. Just like that. And the only thing we need to worry about is getting the spacers, the right spacers for this job, because the two boards together are going to hit if we don't. So let's pick a, I'm tired of using those, so let's use a 4mm. Let's grab a 4mm and see if that does it. Actually does a very good job of separating these. So now I'm going to push this up, and I'm going to add a 1mm spacer here, right? And then I'm going to do the nylon fastener. And the reason for that is I do not want to tear up that rubber, the soft mount, so or the insert there. So I put a, oh yeah, that's not the right screw. So I put a 1mm washer there, because it won't spin, and therefore as long as it doesn't turn, we're not going to be stressing out that piece. Now I need to go across the corner here, so we get over here, and yeah, that's looking good. So let's do another 1mm here, just like that. And then we take our nylon spacer, I mean our nylon fastener there. One thing here is try to eyeball it and make sure that your stuff is pretty much the same height all the way through. Okay, it's not very hard to do it. You can just look at how much of the screw comes out past this, past the fastener, for example, and that's a good way to tell. Try to make them all even. Okay. This way the board's not sitting wappy jawed. But you also, you don't want the board loose, and you don't want it crooked, okay? And that looks like a very good setup right there. Everything looks pretty even. I've got a little bit of room over here, but I can also tell that the head of the screw on the bottom is sticking down more. All right, so anyways, so there is the setup now. And I'm very happy with the way this is coming out. It's looking clean. So we have our receiver, right? And this would be for the VT, no, come on. This, where did he put his VTX? Oh, he removed his VTX, that's right. VTX actually went back here. The customer told me he kept it with him when he sent this in. So what I'm gonna do is, instead of mounting the receiver at the top, I'm gonna mount it at the bottom here. And I'll get a piece of double-sided tape. And the reason I do this is, I prefer to be able to peel the tape off if I need to, than have to peel the receiver off, right? So what I'll do is I'll put double-sided tape down on the board. Let me wipe that. These are alcohol wipes, so they'll clean and make it good there to fasten. All right. Let's do something like that, right? And then there's definitely room for a zip tie here, but what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this off. All right. Like that, and then I'm going to put a hot glue down here, just like that. All right, and then I'm going to put the receiver down. Okay, put the receiver right there. Now, you can get to it to bind it, that shouldn't be a problem at all, and you can actually run the zip tie around it, which is what I'm going to do now. So when you add all these components, when you add all these things together, this is going to be one solid receiver that's not going to be going anywhere. Just run that through, there we go. I'm noticing out of the corner of my eye that my Yorkie is stuck outside, so hold on a second. I need to open this up pretty good. In. Noodles, look inside. Come on. Let's go. Come on, Mom. Go inside. Okay, so now that that's done, sorry guys, now that that's done, got the receiver on well, all right. I can't do anything with the VTX because the customer has that still, but I can make sure that this is all going to fit perfectly, and it is. So that works out well also. Okay, and I'll let him run his antenna when he gets the pieces back on. So you see, because this is broken here, so we're going to have to get another one of these. And then let me see what else we got. Okay, so the next thing will be obviously the camera. I believe he did send me his camera. Let me check for that. This VTX belongs to this gentleman. And the question now is this his camera? There were two. Or is this his camera? And I believe that based on this frame, let me just check and verify for sure. Yeah, this is going to be his camera right here. So let's go ahead and clean that up a little bit. There we go. Ooh, that's broken too. Shoot. All right. This man has really, he works these parts good, man. He flies hard. That's the way it's supposed to be, you know what I mean? Fly hard, man. Have fun. That's the idea. Don't be too scared to enjoy it. All right, so here goes. Let's make sure this is going to fit properly, and it is. So that's good. So I'm going to go ahead and get this wire set up in here. Now, without a VTX, we are kind of stuck, but at least I know for sure that everything else is going to be working. Let's drop that here, and then let's see if I have that kit. What happened with it? This is going to be interesting. I've got to find it, and I don't know if I'm going to find it, so give me 1 second. I'll just have to grab another one, I suppose. You know what? I'll just take the sector off here. Let's see. This is the one that I made. Right, where I redid. These are custom arms. Right? These are the. Oh, you see that? These are the Cyclone. These are custom arms that I designed for the sector. And since I don't really feel like digging through the stuff because my wife will kick my butt, I'm just going to go ahead and take parts off this frame. And then I will dig through the stuff later. So I'm going to just do that real quick. Two, three, four, five. Oh my God, there's so many darn screws. Six. Works. This is the trash cart, so we'll throw that out. Let me take this camera mount here. And let's place that. Let's see if we can get this to fit without beating it up. There's one side. And there's the other side. All right, so I think we're good now.
Yep.
Perfect. Okay, so that's good. And we'll get the top on. So those need to come out. Well, I don't want to give mine up, so I'll tell you what, let mine go. I like those too much to just let them go, so I'll keep them and see what we've got here. All right. Guess I'm gonna have to let mine go. Darn it. Same for this one. More screws, and this thing is ready to fire up and see what happens. Let's hope for the best. There we go. So far, this looks like it's right on track to be working fine. Let's go ahead and plug in our USB. Plug in our power. Oh man, that's beautiful. Let's connect, reset, put our configuration here. All right, let's go to motors, and let's see what we got. Okay, so we got motor two. Oh, these are all up each other. Never mind, motor three. Got a bent bell. All right, that's it. So other than that, though, thing runs like a champ, so all I gotta do now is just update the firmware and get this sucker out and back to its customer. Send it back home. Okay, so guys, I hope that has been helpful for you. Everything seems to be working. So we've replaced what we needed because we went through some pretty bad hits though, so but everything looks good. All the arms are intact and it looks extremely well put together, well done. So, all right, so customer will have to put his antenna back when he's done putting in his VTX, but left him plenty of room there. This works, so I'm gonna go ahead and do a motor resource. Now, I guess you can also do that while you're watching here. So, we do have a bent bell. We might even have two of them. So, let me see if I can see what I got here, because I've got nothing spinning properly. So I'm gonna see if I can take this belt off carefully and okay, it's one. Need help, babe? Alright. Take this one off as well. So it looks like we might actually have two bent bells from this little accident. We'll find out here in a second. That's very strange. Alright. So I'm going to go grab a turn the soldering iron off, heat gun off. I'm going to grab the drill here real quick. This is what we did once before. So, oh yeah. All right, so you can feel the warp in that one. Jamie? Oh, that's, hold on, that's my boy right there. Hey, bud. Hey, I'm in the middle of a lot. Are you playing?
Oh, sorry.
It's okay. Are you playing? What are you going to play? What are you playing?
It's like Faded.
Faded? What's Faded?
You never die. Hold on,
Dad. No. He calls me and I get put on hold. And then he hangs up on me. That's awesome. Excuse me 1 second. Yes, sir.
Sorry.
It's okay. What you got?
I was just trying to
fade it. Okay, wait. Are you gonna play right now? Okay.
Oh, no. If you have to get off, I'll play.
No, I'm in a live video, but you know what? Let me just tell everybody, look, my son's gonna play me a song real quick. If y'all want, you can fast forward past this part, but I'm gonna hear him. So go ahead. Let's hear what you got.
Yeah.
But then when you're done, I gotta get off the phone, okay, so I can finish up.
Okay.
apologize, dude. I'm excited. I love hearing you.
Okay.
So proud of you, dude. You're kicking some serious butt in that. I'm proud of you, bud. Giving you a big thumbs up.
Yes, sir.
All right, and I love you very much.
Love you.
Okay, so if
Fortnite
I get
later.
Huh?
Fortnite later.
Fortnite later, big boy. All right, blow it up. Ready? All right, love you, dude.
Love you.
Peace.
Peace.
Thank you. All right. So let's get back to it. That's awesome. So glad. Woo-wee. Okay, so we have two bent bells, and unfortunately, I don't think I have extra bells, but I'm going to see if I've got something that might be a good substitute, because you don't have to have that brand at all, actually. That part doesn't matter. You can be very close. So let me see if I've got anything that might work. So that's going to be a... Oh. No, no, and no. Let me see how this feels. Let me see what this is like. Actually, that looks like a very close fit. And that is a 2306. And these are 2306. So I'm going to see if I can get this one to stay. And I think I can. So let's try that one first. Too bad. It was close, but it doesn't want to go. Darn it. So let's take that off. If I can. Oh, it's got a smaller. Yeah, that's not going to work. Darn you, Emacs. Alright, so that's out. And I don't think I have any 2306s left. But figure might as well just try anything right now, see if I can get anything to go, and nope, none of the rest of these are going to do. 2306 would be like a, this, let me see, I think I actually do have, I think this is a 2306, isn't it? No, it's not, but it would be close. Yeah, that's about, oh man, does that run smooth? That's huge. That's not impossible. That's nice. Come on. Nope. This one, nope, Oh well, I'll have to find two bells that are gonna fit.
All right, let me check. Oh, oh, that's a bell. Okay, so as far as this goes, two bells do need to be replaced. I will have to find the right bells for that. I thought I had some, but I guess not. Everything else looks good, and I know the motors are running fine. So I'm just gonna find the bells to replace it, and then we should be set. And let me see, I don't think there's anything wrong with these motors. Yeah, no, these are smooth. So, let me see. Yeah. So, all right, I gotta find some bells, but other than that, guys, this is gonna be set. I'll come back and do the rest of the video. But here you go, I mean, this thing went from being smashed in smithereens to pretty much ready to fly again. It's been cleaned up, parts have been replaced, and got a new makeover, I guess is what they call it. Customer does have the VTX still, so I cannot connect that. He'll have to do that when he gets back. This will be going into the RMA. So that is a bad ESC, and it is gone for good. And let me see what else we got. No, I guess that's about it. So the next one will be working on. We'll bring out this one next. We'll be working on this one next. They got smashed into a brick wall or something, all right? So guys, that's it. That's just a little thing about repairing these. It's what I do most of the time, so when I'm not building or doing whatever, so I figure I'd just share those videos with you. You can watch them or not. And then, as always, I want to say what's up to my son. Excellent playing today, Jaden. I'm proud of you, bud. And I'll see you on Fortnite in just a little bit, okay? All right, guys, if you have any questions, you can always email me on my website. There's the address. And then please, as always, follow us on Facebook, and also please subscribe to our YouTube channel. As always, please spend time with your family, guys. You never know how much time you have left, so make the most of it. You can always fly later, okay? Other than that, God bless. Be safe. Have a great weekend. We'll talk to you soon. Peace.